The Pandora Papers. Thousands of documents have been released which reveal the financial details of some of the richest and most famous people in the world. I'm Neil and this is News Review from BBC Learning English. Joining me today is Roy. Hello, Roy.
Hi, Neil, and hello, everybody. If you would like to test yourself on the vocabulary around this story, all you need to do is head to our website, bbclearningenglish.com, to take a quiz. But now let's hear more about this story from this BBC news report.
A huge leak of financial documents has exposed the secret dealings of hundreds of politicians, world leaders and billionaires. They show the King of Jordan secretly bought properties in London, Washington and Malibu. His lawyers have dismissed the information as neither accurate nor up to date. The files also show that Tony Blair purchased an offshore company that owned a house in London, saving his family hundreds of thousands of pounds in stamp duty. No rules were broken.
So, a large number of documents have been obtained by the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists. 140 news agencies around the world are working on these documents, including the BBC and The Guardian in the UK. These documents expose the financial lives and money dealings of many politicians and rich people around the world. These documents have been called the Pandora Papers.
And you've been looking around the various news websites and picking out interesting vocabulary we can use to talk about this story and beyond the story. What have you got?
We have leak, caught up in, and tsunami.
Leak, caught up in, and tsunami. Okay, let's start then with your first headline, please, Roy.
So our first headline comes from the UK, from The Guardian, and it reads, Pandora Papers, biggest ever leak of offshore data exposes financial secrets of rich and powerful.
Leak, release of secret or private information.
Okay, so leak is spelled L-E-A-K, and it can be used as both a verb and a noun. A leak or to leak?
Yeah, now it might be useful to think of this word in its more kind of literal sense. So for example, the other day I noticed there was a big damp patch on the ceiling in my house. But what could that be? I called a plumber. A plumber came along and said that my pipe had a leak. It had a leak. It meant that liquid was escaping from this pipe. And it's useful to think about this in the same way, isn't it?
Absolutely. So when water travels through a pipe, it's usually contained in the pipe. It's the same for gas. Now, when the pipe is compromised, maybe there's a crack in the pipe, water starts to come out of the pipe. It's no longer contained. And this word we use, we say leak. Water is leaking from the pipe or leaking out of the pipe. Same with gas as well. And it's the same idea in the headline. Now, this information that we're talking about should be private or secret, but it is leaking out. It is leaked into the press.
Yeah, and it's not accidental, is it? Somebody has decided to reveal this information, but we don't often know who the person is who decided to reveal the information. It's often done by politicians who want... Maybe they want to get some criticism aimed at a colleague and they get this information released somehow that makes somebody else look bad.
Absolutely, yep. More often than not, it's intentional. Now, obviously, it can be an accidental leak, but as you say, it's more often something intentional. Somebody wants to expose somebody or some information. There is another thing we need to talk about as well. Now, you may be aware there is a vegetable also called a leek. It's the same pronunciation, but this is spelled L-E-E-K. And it's a long white vegetable with green at the top. And I believe it comes from the onion family.
Yeah. Tastes a bit like an onion, doesn't it? But it's kind of long instead.
It does. It does. And it's commonly used in soup, leek and potato soup. But it has no kind of link to the word leak that we're talking about, the L-E-A-K. Unless there's a crack in the bowl of soup and then your leek soup is leaking.
Okay, that's definitely time now to get a summary. Okay, well, talking about water, we have a story about slippery toilets, which can help save millions of litres of water. What do our viewers have to do to watch that, Roy?
All you need to do is click the link in the description.
Okay, let's have a look at your next headline.
Okay, so our next headline comes from the UK, from the Daily Mail, and it reads, from Claudia Schiffer to Shakira, the rich and famous faces caught up in the Pandora Papers leak.
Caught up in, involved in a bad situation unexpectedly.
Yes, so the expression here is caught up in, and this expression is commonly used with the verbs be or the verb get. So you can be caught up in something or get caught up in something. And it's commonly used when we're trapped in a situation that that is unexpected and it's a bad or annoying or awkward situation.
Yeah, I think there's a key, isn't there, in the first word there, caught, which is the past tense of catch. And when you catch something, there's a sense of it being trapped, isn't there?
Yeah, so for example, you throw me a ball, I catch it in my hands, and it is trapped. It won't drop from there. And it's exactly the same idea. These people are trapped in this situation. They are involved in the situation. So when they're caught up in it, they are trapped or involved in this situation. Now, it's important to mention it's often unexpected or unintentional. Now, these people could have been doing something wrong and therefore they didn't expect to be exposed, or it could have been completely unintentional and they've got caught up in this situation.
Yeah, when you say that someone is caught up in a situation, it doesn't necessarily mean that they are ultimately guilty.
Yeah, that's true. And it's normally very negative. It's normally negative. For example, you say caught up in a difficult or bad situation, caught up in a scandal.
We wouldn't use it for a positive situation that you were involved in. You wouldn't say, I'm caught up in a lottery victory or something like that.
No, you would not. Although I would love to be caught up in a lottery win. there is another meaning of to be caught up in something. And this is when you're so involved in something that you don't realize that something else is happening. So maybe you're reading a really, really good book and you're so caught up in the book, but your mom or your partner, they're calling you and you don't hear them. You don't realize that they're calling you because you're so involved in this book.
Yeah, this happens to me on the underground going to work. I'll be so caught up in my book, I'll miss the stop and I have to get off and change train and be late for
maybe
work.
Maybe it's time to set the alarm on your watch so you know when to get off or stop reading.
Okay, let's get a summary. Now, 6 Minute English has got so many fascinating topics, it's impossible not to get caught up in them. And we've got one about language, which is just really interesting, isn't it, Roy?
Yes, it is. All you need to do to see that is click the link in the description.
Okay, let's have a look at our next headline, please.
Okay, so our next headline comes from the ICIJ, or the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists, and it reads, Pandora Papers, an offshore data tsunami.
Tsunami, arrival of something in huge amounts.
Yes, so this word is spelt T-S-U-N-A-M-I. Now, in English with native speakers, you will commonly hear it without the pronunciation of the T. So they just say tsunami, the T is silent. But it's important to recognize that this is a loan word that comes from Japanese. And I believe in Japanese, the T is pronounced, so it's tsunami. But it's very difficult for a lot of English native speakers to say that, so we just say tsunami.
Yeah, so a tsunami is an enormous wave, isn't it? So why are we talking about huge waves when we're talking also about data and financial information?
Well, yeah, you're absolutely right. It can relate to that huge wave that washes everything away. But we also use it to talk about an arrival of a huge amount of something. So, for example, information or data or even people. There could be a tsunami of visitors to your city or something. So it's about an arrival of a large amount of something, which is, it kind of makes sense when you're thinking about the large amount of water that is arriving.
We also, we have other expressions connected to water that have a similar meaning, don't we? For example, deluge. If you say there is a deluge of something, deluge is a very heavy downpour of rain that washes things away. We can talk about a deluge in the same way about something that has a large impact.
Yes, and we can also say a flood of information, linking back to that water idea, or a tidal wave of data. So we use these water expressions to talk about a huge amount of information or data arriving at the same time. And it's very important to say we commonly use this word like tsunami to exaggerate the amount of something. So for example, I might say, oh, I've just had a tsunami of emails arrive in my inbox, and there might be only 3 or 4, but I'm just being a little bit dramatic and exaggerated.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's get a summary. Time now, Roy, then, for a recap of the vocabulary we've heard today.
Yes, we had leak, release of secret or private information. We had caught up in, involved in a bad situation unexpectedly. And we had tsunami, the arrival of something in huge amounts.
If you want to test yourself on the vocabulary, there's a quiz on our website at bbclearningenglish.com, and you can also find us all over social media. Thanks for joining us, and see you next time. Goodbye.
Bye.